So welcome to my channel, and I have lots of problems for you which are very interesting, but currently I'm not getting time for making videos, but I promise you I will make one video per day. And today I pick a problem from Csir-net exam 2015, which is on heat reaction. Okay, so this problem is very much interesting and very important. If you don't know the problem, you cannot just figure it out in exam hall. I am not saying that all of you, but you should know, you should practice this problem at once before appearing in the exam, because it is not so straightforward. So before talking about the problem, I would like to simply tell you what is Haig reaction, the basic things and the mechanism of the Haig reaction. Okay, so Haig reaction is basically a cross coupling reaction between aryl halide or aryl tosylate, aryl mesylate. So if any leaving group is attached to the aromatic ring, or it may be any vinyl halide also. Okay, so vinyl iodide, vinyl bromide, chloride, or other any leaving groups are there. So either aryl or vinyl. Okay, so it may be aryl halide or vinyl. I am telling halide, but it is applicable for tosylate, mesylate, and other with other leaving groups also. Okay, so the Haig reaction is basically the cross coupling between, let's say, aryl halide and an alkene, or an alkene like this. So this is your R1, this is your alkene, this is your aryl halide, and this reaction is catalyzed by palladium zero. So what you will get? You will get a couple product. So CC bond will form. Okay, this CC bond will be formed. Now instead of aryl halide, if you use a vinyl halide, let's say this is your vinyl halide which has trans configuration, then your product will also have trans configuration. So stereochemistry of the center is retained in the product. So this is your Haig reaction. Now what is the mechanism of the Haig reaction? I will briefly discuss the catalytic cycle of the reaction. So let's say this is your vinyl halide. Okay, so first step is, when you give palladium zero catalyst, it undergoes oxidative addition. The first step is oxidative addition. So this vinyl halide undergoes oxidative addition in this palladium center. Okay, so you will get this. Now it is zero, it is 16 electron complex. After undergoing this oxidative addition, it remains 16 electron, but its oxidation state changed from 0 to plus 2. Now second step is, in the second step, so your alkene is present. This alkene will add to this palladium. Okay, so a bond will be formed between this alkene and the palladium. So now your palladium is in plus 2 oxidation state, but it is 18 electron complex. I am not writing the other ligands present in it. Actually, another two ligands will be present. So there will be, this may be phosphine, triphenyl phosphine ligands also. So this may be present. And if you count the electron, then it will be 18, 16 in this case. And in this case also, the phosphine ligands will be present, and it is 18 electron. So for the clarity, I am omitting these ligands. Okay. So you should know that it is 16 electron, and after this, it becomes 18 electron. Now, the next step is beta migration. What is beta migration? This group with its electron pair migrate here, and a new bond formed between this palladium and this carbon. Okay, so basically it may migrate on this carbon also, or it may migrate on this carbon, and this will dictated by the steric hindrance factor. So I am not discussing that. You for that moment, for simple discussion of this mechanism, we just suppose that this bond is migrating to this center. So what you will get? You will get this iodide over here, and this is your R. Now this bond is, this center is attached to this palladium center, and your bond migrates here. Sorry, you have this, right? So this part is migrate. So if you count the carbon atom, this is 1, 2, this is 1, 2, and this is 1, 2, this is 1, 2. So 4 carbons are there. This is all right. Now the final step is what? So final step is basically your beta hydride elimination. So here will be a beta hydride present. So this is alpha, this is beta. This beta hydride goes eliminate and you will get a double bond. So you will get a product like this. This is your R and this is your product. This CC bond is formed here. These two partner adds together to give this product, and you get your palladium, hydrogen, iodine. Next, it will go reductive elimination to give you again palladium zero, and this occurs in presence of base, so you have to use base, and you will eliminate HI. So this is reductive elimination step, and you will regenerate your palladium zero catalyst. So this is a true catalyst because after the full reaction, it is regenerated. So basically, what is the main thing here is that this component. So this component is adds. This component adds on here. So this component adds on here, and this new carbon-carbon bond is forming here. Okay. So this new carbon-carbon bond is forming here between this component and this component. So you have vinyl halide or aryl halide and your alkene, and you end up with your cross-coupled product. Okay. Now the problem given in the exam was this. So this is your substrate. You have a cyanide group here, and now this is your compound given, and you are given with palladium acetate, palladium diacetate, and a base like AgCO3 silver carbonate, and I think trithylamine or maybe so. So this role of this base is basically to reduce this palladium 2 to palladium 0. Okay. They reduce this palladium 2 to palladium 0, which is the active catalyst for the Heck reaction. Now you are given this compound, so you have to identify the two components for Heck reaction. Now this is your vinyl halide part, and this is your olefin part. So it will be a coupling reaction between this center, and either it can add over here or it can add over here. Now you may think that to add in this position is easier because it is 1 2 3 4 5, 5 member ring is easy to form, and also it will generate a strain free bicyclic product, whereas if it's add here, it will generate a strain product, and when I will do the mechanism, it will be more clear. Okay, so as I mentioned earlier, the first step will be simple oxidative addition of this alkyl halide. So you will get so this is your palladium, and you have your oxidative addition. So this now palladium is 2. So in this case, palladium was 0, it becomes 2, and you have your methyl group here. Okay. Now this bond will interact with it, as I said previously. Now in this step, this beta migratory insertion will occur. So this next step is beta migratory insertion. Now you can see that to migrate this bond over there is much easier than migrate this bond over there. So it will migrate at the center, and bond is formed between palladium and this in the center. So you will getting intermediate this. You will get an intermediate this palladium and iodine. Okay. Now, from this, you can get two products. Okay. So next step is our beta elimination, beta hydride elimination. Okay. And you have here, you have two beta hydrogen, and in this terminal also you have one beta hydrogen. So either this hydrogen or any of these two hydrogen can eliminate it. And if you eliminate this hydrogen, this red hydrogen, you will get a product this. Okay, and cyanide is there. And if you eliminate that green hydrogen, this green hydrogen, any of this green hydrogen, you will get product like so. Sorry, I did a mistake. In this case, the double bond will be here. Okay, as you can see, the double bond will be here because this center is forming bond to this center. Here it is bond forming between this center and this center, so double bond will be here. Okay, so in this case also the double bond will be here, and here the product will be, if the green hydrogen gets eliminated, then the product will be this one. Okay, and now interestingly, in the question paper, both of the options are given. This option was also given and this option was also given. And if you know little bit about the basic of organic chemistry, that conjugated double bond is stabler than isolated double bonds because of the conjugation. So this is a conjugated double bond. This is a full conjugation between these two double bond, and in this case it is separated by this sp3 carbon atom. So you can easily predict that this product will be much more stable than this, and this will be your answer. Okay, so this is your answer. Now, if you tick this answer as correct, you will get 0 mark. Okay, so in this case, you have to you I ignored the stereochemistry of the reaction, and if you do the same thing in exam, you will end up with this wrong product. Okay, so what is mean by stereochemistry? So in this step, what I have written here, so in this step I said that beta migration is happening. Okay, now you can see that this beta migration, when it happens, it has to occur either from the top face of this alkene or from the bottom face of this alkene, right? Because it has two phases, one is bottom phase, one is top phase. And I didn't mention any stereochemistry here, but I should mention stereochemistry here. Now you can see that this cyanide group is at the top phase, so this group will be at the bottom phase. And you know that for a five membered ring, you cannot draw or you cannot get a cis trans configuration. This should be cis cis. So this both of these bonds should be in the downward side. That means if this bond is downside, this migration will also occur from the bottom side of this alkene. So it will migrate from the bottom side of this alkene. So this bond is dotted bond. It represents that both of these bonds are from the bottom side. So this bond is forming from the bottom side of this alkene. And if it happens, this palladium has to be in the bottom side. Okay. So this palladium also has to be bottom side because migratory insertion is a concerted process, and both of I shown by the arrow that this is a concerted process, and it is involving a four member type ring, 1 2 3 4, only four membered cyclic transition state. Okay, and it cannot be trans, it should be cis. So that means if this is in the bottom side, this will also be bottom side. And the consequence of this is that this hydrogen will be at the top side. Okay, and in this case, one hydrogen is bottom, one hydrogen is top, right? One is top, this one is top side, this one is in the downside. Okay, now one thing I didn't mention is that the beta hydride elimination, whatever is, so this is, let's say, your substrate. You have your beta hydride elimination from here. So this is your palladium and this is your hydrogen. So for beta hydride elimination, like this beta migratory insertion, it should also attain a four-membered cyclic transition state like this. Okay, so this is a four-membered cyclic transition state. I can represent it more better like this. Okay, so this is your four-membered cyclic transition state, and it should always be seen. So the relation between this hydrogen and this palladium should always be seen Then only it can undergo beta hydride elimination. Now, if you look at this particular site, you can see that this palladium is downside, as represented by this dotted bond, but this hydrogen is at the top side. So they are anti. And due to this cyclic structure, rotation around this bond is not possible. Okay, so this will the relation between them will be always anti, and that's why elimination of this hydrogen is not possible. Now in this case, you have one hydrogen which is top side and one is bottom side. So this bottom hydrogen is perfectly aligned for beta hydride elimination, and you will, if you eliminate this, you will end up with this non-conjugated double bond. Okay, so in this case it will be non-conjugated, so double bond will be in this side. So in this case you get a product which is thermodynamically less stable, and if you think that you know the Heck reaction is very simple reaction, you just predict the product, you will get a wrong product. So you have to do the full mechanism to get into the right product, and that's why I am suggesting you that in CSIR exam you should always do the full reaction mechanism. If you know the mechanism well, then also you should do it, because it will help you from getting negative marks. And I think this video will be helpful for you. If it is helpful for you, then please share it, and if you like this video, then give a thumbs up and also subscribe my channel.